Why did the Constitutional Court reject austerity measures between 2012 to 2014?
So the Constitutional Court rejected some of the measures, not all measures. The measures fell basically into two categories. Some of the measures involved pay cuts in the public sector and the slashing of pensions, and other measures concerned broadening the basis for firing civil servants. The court rejected only a few of these measures, and it did so on the basis of constitutional principles, particularly three: the principles of equality, of proportionality, and of the protection of legitimate expectations.
Do you believe the Portuguese Constitutional Court acted appropriately in its rulings on austerity measures?
I don't think the court acted appropriately in its rulings on these measures for a number of reasons. I don't think that the court was sufficiently appreciative of the reasonableness of the austerity measures. On the other hand, I think that the court's case law was very unpredictable, that the basis on which the court decided these cases, invoking very indeterminate concepts such as excessiveness and reasonableness, the fact that the measures are unnecessary, created a great deal of uncertainty about what the court would decide next time. A third reason is that I think the court acted beyond the legitimate scope of its competence. A fourth and final reason why I think these decisions were inadequate is the fact that the court was not sufficiently attentive to the supranational context within which the Portuguese government acted.
How is transnational governance affecting the role of Portugal's constitutional court?
One way in which transnational governance is affecting the constitutional court is, of course, that the court has been asked on a number of occasions to scrutinize measures that were taken by the elected branches on the basis of programs that were designed and the application of which was monitored by international institutions. And this creates a lot of trouble for domestic courts, because domestic courts realize that many of the decisions that are made by national authorities are decisions that are heavily based on material that comes from abroad and higher levels of governance. So the question is, what should courts do in the face of that? And my feeling is that on many occasions, courts have had the temptation to scrutinize very harshly decisions that are made by national authorities in order to make up for a legitimacy deficit of the choices that were imported from abroad. Unfortunately, I think that this creates a paradox. The paradox is that those authorities that have greater democratic legitimacy, national political authorities, are placed between, if you want, the on the one hand, the global governance, global institutions that are dictating much of the policy choices that they need to take, and on the other hand, they have to face national courts that are extremely demanding with respect to them.